Hello students, welcome to Target AES. I hope you are having a wonderful day. Let us start a very fresh subject of our crash course, which is building materials. Which is building material. A very simple subject and very scoring subject. From here, if you are a decent student, even if you are above average student, you will be able to answer all the questions. If 14 questions come, you will be able to answer all the 14 questions for sure. And there are only 3 formulae in the entire building material, so the chances of questions, the problematic questions, are very less. 99.9% you will be having theory questions only, and you will be easily able to do if you have listened to my module. Okay, so this is the ESC syllabus. If you are not aware, you can take a screenshot. And moreover, this is a theory subject, right? Out and out theory subject. So I thought it is not a better option to write a short notes, because you might be missing some point if you are writing the short notes. It is a theory one, right? So you are not sure that kunsa bit puchne wala exam. So better you underline the important points in the notebook itself. You might be having the notebook given by Target AES, right? So notebook aap open kar lena. Hamari jo bhi material humne provide kiya hai, hum usi se important points highlight kar lenge. I will stress on the important points, and it will be more than enough for you. Okay, just be perfect in important points whatever I am teaching. In the very first module, I am going to finish the entire chapter of bricks. Okay, we are going to see the entire chapter of bricks. What is the modular size of brick? Very important bit. What is the modular size of brick? Answer kya hai? It is 19 centimeter. Okay, this is 19 centimeter. ARK 9 centimeter and ARK 9 centimeter. So 19 into 9 into 9 is your standard size or modular size of brick. First important. So what is the nominal size of? What is the nominal size of? See, whenever you are keeping the brick in your masonry, whenever you are keeping the brick in masonry, a mortar bhi aayega na beech mein. So if you are considering center to center, it will be, you just have to add 1 to this extra. So it will become what? 20 into 10 into 10. It is known as nominal size of modular. I hope it is very clear, right? Now, another very important bit. What is the weight of 1 meter cube of brick earth? If I am keeping 1 meter cube of bricks stacked together, okay, 1 meter cube of bricks stacked together, aap rakh lo, to kitna ho jayega aapka weight? The weight will be approximately 1800 kg. What will be the weight? The weight will be 1800 kg. I hope it is very clear, right? And what is the average weight of each brick? One brick will be approximately 3 to 3.5 kg. Another very important weight. And what is the weight per 1 meter cube? That will be 1800 kg. Nahi bulna hai, kabhi nahi bulna hai, okay? So let us continue with the second important point of today's class. That is, on the top of a brick, you will be having a small cut like this. Okay, you will be having a small cut like this. Isse hum kya bolte hai? Is indent ko hum kya bolte hai? We call it as frog. We call it as frog. What is the depth of this frog? 1 to 2 centimeters. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? 1 to 2 centimeters ka hum ek indent banate hain. Why we are providing this? Because it will act as a key to hold the mortar above your brick. I hope it is very clear, right? Because brick kya hai? It will be having a straight surface. So mortar kahan pe rukega? For that, what we are having? We are having an indent. So yahan pe thoda mortar rukega. I hope it is very clear, right? What is the purpose of providing frog? To form a key for holding the mortar, and therefore bricks are laid with frogs on top. I hope it is very clear, right? Yaad rahega. And what is the size of frog? It will be generally 10 into 4 into 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter in depth indent. I hope it is very clear. Yahan tak yaad rakh loge. So all points whatever I am teaching are important, and he points aapke exam mein aane ke maximum chances hai. Okay. And next, we have a test for good bricks. Remember, this is a test for good bricks. This is not for IS code book. As per IS code book, I will teach you later on. See how to know whether the bricks whatever you have bought are good bricks or not. So what you have to do is, you have to keep 20 bricks together. You have to keep 20 bricks together. So each brick ka length kitna? 19. So 20 bricks, if you are keeping together, what will be the length? 19 into 20, which will be 380. Agreed or not? So it should be plus or 12. So that is 368 to 398 centimeter. If the length is satisfying in this range, then we will be considering it as good brick. Similarly for height also, you will be stacking 20 bricks. So each height is 9 centimeter. So 9 into 20 will be 180 plus or minus 6. Remember, for 19 centimeter dimension, it was plus or minus 12. And for 9 centimeter dimension, it is plus or minus 6. Okay, this is in general. Yaad rakhlo, this is in general. This is not the exact one. This is not for IS code. IS code gives a tolerance limit. Yaad rakhlo. What is the tolerance limit as per IS code? It is not plus or minus 12, but plus or minus 8 when it comes to 19 centimeter side, and remaining side, it is not plus or minus 6. It is only plus or minus 4. 8 and 4. Remember these two, very important. Yehi important hai if you are seeing some option. As per IS code book, hum jayenge. So you should tick plus or minus 8 or plus or minus 4, depending upon the dimension which he is talking about. Okay, now let's see what is the classification of bricks. Bricks can be classified into two groups. My bricks can be classified as unburnt bricks and burnt bricks. Okay, so unburnt bricks, obviously, name itself says it is not burnt. We are just drying my bricks in sunlight and more than enough. Okay, so obviously they will be not having much strength. I hope you got it. Unburnt bricks are sun dried after molding into shape. They are used for only temporary structure and steep structures because they will not have much strength, they will not have fire resistance, they will not have most of the properties which our good bricks contain. Therefore, we cannot use it for permanent structures, only for temporary and cheap structures we can use. But mostly whatever brick we are buying in market, that will be burnt brick only. Again, this burnt brick is divided into four classes. Okay, my burnt brick is divided into four classes. First class, second class, third class, and fourth class. So let us see the first class. Very important, these bricks are the excellent bricks. Please remember about the properties of the first class brick. Very frequently asked it. They are thoroughly burnt. And what is the color of these bricks? They will be deep red, cherry or copper color. What is the color of first class bricks? Deep red, cherry or copper color. And remember, they will be excellent. No, though, so obviously what will be the flaws? The flaws will be negligible. They will be free from flaws, cracks or any stones. And whenever you are stuck in two first class bricks, okay, if you are just two bricks ko aap marna ek dusre se like tuck tuck, you will be getting a clear metallic sound. A clear metallic or ringing sound is get when we are striking two first class bricks together. And this point is the most important. The water absorption of the first class brick should not be greater than how much percent of its weight? Should not be greater than 20% of its weight. And what is the crushing strength? It should be greater than equals to 10 newton per mm square. Okay. So for external walls, for load bearing walls, all this will be using first class bricks only. I hope it is very clear. Yaad rahega. And moreover, whatever bricks you have, right, it will be having a sharp faces. Ye jo face ban raha hai, the faces, whatever it has a sharp faces, not like undulations. The brick will not be like this. Okay, the brick will not have undulations like this. It will be straight and sharp. Okay, so next is the second class bricks. Very similar, but here water absorption, it should not be greater than how much? 22%. For first class, 20%. For second class, it should not be greater than 22%. Should not be greater than 20%, and here it should not be greater than 22%. And the strength was greater than equal to 10 newton per mm square. Here it is greater than equal to 7 newton per mm square. 7 newton per mm square. Generally, interior work ke liye jo bhi hum bricks use karte, it will be made up of second class bricks. Next is the third class brick. These are the underburnt bricks. As per IS code book, the strength whatever we have to use of a brick na, it should be greater than equal to 5.5 newton per mm. 5.5 newton per mm. In the third class bricks, they are actually unburnt bricks. They will not have that much amount of strength, or the required amount of strength. Generally, it will be around 3.5 newton per mm square ke paas hi rahega. The strength of these third class bricks are very less. They are unburnt bricks. And the water absorption is about 25% of its dry weight. Only you can use it for temporary structures or partition walls like that only. It cannot take any load, so you cannot use it as load bearing walls. I hope it is very clear. Next is fourth class bricks. Fourth class bricks are overburnt. Yaad rakhlo, third class bricks were underburnt, whereas my fourth class bricks are overburnt. And obviously, as they are overburnt, their shape will be distorted. They will not have a standard shape. The shape will be distorted, and these type of bricks are generally called as Jama bricks. Jama bricks. Okay. So what is the use of these bricks? Hum kuch bhi nahi karenge. If there is some filling purpose, road filling or foundation filling ke liye, we will be using it to fill as a filler material. This is the use of fourth class bricks or Jama. Okay. I hope it is very clear for you. The main purpose of this Jama bricks are, we don't use it for construction, we generally use it only for as a filling material. Done? Yaad rakhoge. And there is one more important type of brick which is called as heavy duty. This is called as heavy duty brick. Generally, iska strength kitna rahega? It should be greater than or equal to 40 newton per mm. See, whatever I have taught you, first class, second class, third class, fourth class, this was for building purpose. This was, but if you are talking about heavy loads, for example, bridges layer, obviously the loads whatever are there, it will be much higher. If you are talking about industrial buildings mein kya rehta hai? Obviously the machinery is very heavy, so the load we acting on these bricks are also very heavy, agreed or not? So the bricks what we'll be using, we'll be using what? Heavy duty bricks. We'll be using what? Heavy duty bricks. And iska strength kitna rehta hai? It is greater than equal to 40 newton per mm square, and water absorption is limited to 5%. So heavy duty and first class compare karo. Heavy duty, the strength should be greater than 40, and first class it should be greater than 10. Water absorption, it should not be greater than 5. Here water absorption should not be greater than 20. I hope it is very clear, right? Now next, we also have classification of bricks based on burning, like pale bricks if they are underburnt. अगर ब्रिक सीधा से बर्न नहीं हुआ तो थोड़ा पेल पेल दिखेगा, सो वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज पेल ब्रिक्स. जनरली इफ यू हैव अ क्लीन, इफ यू हैव अ क्लीन, व्हाट इज क्लीन वी विल स्टडी इन डिटेल. सो फ्रॉम इनर साइड द ब्रिक्स विल बी वेल बर्न एज वी आर मूविंग आउट. ये क्या होगा, यहाँ पे इतना एनर्जी नहीं मिलेगा इनको, राइट, इतना फ्यूल नहीं मिलेगा, सो दे विल बी लाइक लिटिल बिट अंडर बर्न. ओके, सो जनरली एट द एंड्स ऑफ योर क्लीन विल बी हैविंग दिस पेल ब्रिक्स. In the middle, we will be having body bricks. They are well burnt and अच्छे bricks है. Central portion में आपको मिल जाएंगे. These are body bricks and we have arch bricks at the center. These bricks, what happened as they are very close to fuel, they are overburnt. Agreed or not? These are overburnt and known as clinker bricks obtained from inner portion of kiln. Inner portion में हमें मिलते हैं arch brick. In the central portion, we will be getting body brick and in outer portion, we will be getting plain bricks. I hope it is very clear, right? So we can also classify the brick based on its types, like solid brick. In solid brick, obviously it is saying the holes, whatever the tiny tiny holes na, their percentage is very less. Okay, the holes, it should not be exceeding more than 25%. I hope it is very clear, right? And then we have perforated bricks. Janbujh ke hum kya karte hai? Holes zyada rakhte hai. Isse kya hota hai? Whenever we have perforated, the total holes will be area, the volume of total holes will be greater than 25%. And the good thing is, weight kya ho jayega? Weight of brick kam jayega. That is giving us more advantage that the weight of brick is less now. And it is also acting as a sound insulation. Yaad rakhna, whenever we have this porous bricks, it acts as sound insulation. I hope it is very clear, right? Next is hollow brick. Just like perforation, in perforation we have small, small holes. But in a concrete, we are making big, big holes. Then we'll be calling them as hollow bricks. And we also have cellular bricks. In cellular bricks, what happens is, one side will be having an opening and other side will not be having an opening. Okay. Holes closed at one end exceeding 20% of the volume, it has high thermal insulation. So only at the one end, you'll be having holes closed and other end, the hole will be open. So these type of bricks, whatever we have, we'll be calling it as cellular bricks. I hope you got it. Now this is very important. Yahan se question aane ke chances bahut zyada hai. What is characteristic of good brick? So coming to size and shape, it should be in what shape? It should be in rectangular shape. I hope it is very clear, right? And sharp, straight edges rehna chahiye. And what is the color? Obviously, what is the best brick? First class, second class, third class, fourth class. It is first class. So first class ke brick ke color mein hi rehna chahiye na. To be called as good brick, it should be in a deep red or cherry color. I hope it is very clear, right? And coming to texture and compactness, obviously it should be rough. It should not be too much smooth, or else kya ho jayega? Mortar will slip away and there will be no proper bonding in between two bricks. Okay. Next is hardness and soundness. So hardness, how to get whether the brick is hard or not. So whenever you have a brick, try to scratch it with your finger. If there is no marking falling on your brick, then that means its hardness is sufficient enough. I hope you got it right. Samajh mein aa gaya? And coming to soundness, obviously I have told you right, when two first class bricks are sounded together, you will be getting what? Ringing or metallic sound. I hope it is very clear for you. Now let us see the next one, which is water absorption. You know, whenever I am talking about good brick, it should be, you should relate with what? First class brick. So what is the water absorption? It should not be more than 20% of its dry weight when the substance is immersed in water for 24 hours. I hope it is very clear, right? And there are some more bits. You just have a look, more than enough. Now let us see. This is a very important bit again. No brick should be having a crushing strength below 55 kg per centimeter square or 5.5 newton per mm square as per our code book. Now let us see ingredients of good brick earth. Okay, so brick kis mein se banate hai? Mithi se to banate hai. Bricks are made from what? Soil only, no? So soil mein kya rehta hai mostly? You will be having mostly silica and alumina. So obviously 50 to 60% of your brick is silica only and 20 to 30% of the brick will be alumina only. Okay. I hope it is very clear, right? Almost 70 to 90% will be having just silica and alumina. The rest, you might be having 10% up to 10% of lime, magnesia less than 1%, ferric oxide less than 7%, and alkali is 10%. Remember this, bit is very important. Okay, alkalis we'll study in detail, how much it will be and how much are the limits. Very important term, alkalis. And next, we also have traces of some other elements like carbon dioxide, sulfur trioxide, water, not important. But most important, you have to remember the compositions also. Silica 50 to 60, lime 20 to 30, sorry, alumina 20 to 30, lime 10, magnesia less than 1, ferric oxide less than 7, and alkalis less than or around 10. Okay, the first one is silica. What is the uses of silica? Silica kya dega? It gives durability to my bricks. It prevents shrinkage and warping of my bricks. Ye jo shape change hai na, this whatever silica is there, it traces the shape change. Okay, so whether the temperature is changing or the climatic conditions are changing, this silica whatever is there in my brick, it will make sure that your bricks won't be shrinked or warped. I hope it is very clear, right? But if you are keep on adding more silica, like 50 to 60 is desirable, if you are adding like 70-80% tak chale gaye, what will happen? Excess of silica will make your brick brittle and it will also make it weak on burning. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? Now next is alumina. So whenever we have this alumina, na, alumina is related to plasticity. Yaad rakhlo, it is related to plasticity. Therefore, this alumina, what does it impart? It imparts plasticity to my brick. I hope it is very clear, right? Yaad rakhoge, these are some important bits which you should always remember. And the clays whichever are having this high alumina content, na, they are very refractory. What is the meaning of very refractory? That means they can have high temperature resistance. High temperature resistance. More refractory means more temperature resistance. Okay. Next is lime. See, lime is not a good thing whether it is in cement or whether it is in brick, because it has tendency of getting swollen, right? When it comes in contact with moisture, what will happen? It will start expanding. And when it start expanding, what will happen? Cracks are jayenge. Obviously, baat hai, if there is some lump of lime in your brick and all of the sudden it got some water, now it is expanding. So it will create cracks within your brick. Common sense ki baat hai. So it should be, if it is present, it should be only in finely powdered form. If lumps, then obviously there will be expansion and your brick will be getting what? Cracks, and it will be going to fail. Okay. So what is the main purpose of this lime? The main purpose is to prevent shrinkage on drying. And what will happen if your lime content is more? Again, very important bit. If lime content is more, whenever you are burning these bricks, right? Whenever you are burning in kilns, what will happen to these bricks? These bricks will start to melt, because ye jo lime hai na, because of this bricks, whatever is there, more heat is generated and it is started to melt and it might also lose the shape. I hope it is very clear, right? Magnesia is generally gives a brick a little bit yellowish tint and it rarely exceeds more than 1%. Basically, it is less than 1%, and the main purpose of this magnesia is it decreases shrinkage. Okay, it decreases shrinkage. Now next is iron. Iron kya dega? Obviously color dega. The reddish color of the brick, whatever you are seeing, it is because of iron. I hope it is very clear, right? But if you are adding more iron than needed, then your bricks won't be reddish color. They will be turning into brick dark blue color. I hope it is very clear. So not only the color, but iron kya dega? Strength bhi dega. It will give you strength and hardness. I hope you will be remembering this. And now let us see what are the harmful substances in brick. Lime, obviously harmful. Kyun? You already know it can swell and it will obviously create cracks in your brick. And moreover, it can also change the color of brick from reddish to yellowish color. Next aate pebbles, gravels and grits. Yani pathar. See, whenever you are making the brick, right, you make it with clay only, like clayey material only. You mix it really well. But if you have some stones in between, obviously there won't be having uniform mixture, right? So obviously you will be getting bricks of unsymmetrical strength, right? I hope you are getting it right. So it is not good to have pebbles, gravel and grit in your brick. Next is iron pyrites. Iron pyrites, they have a tendency of decomposing the brick when it is getting burnt. Okay. So what is the problem with iron pyrites? They decompose the bricks when it is getting burnt. And obviously bricks will be splitting into pieces. Okay. So next is alkalis. Alkalis is very important. Give it 5 star. A super duper important bit. So in general, what should be the percentage of alkalis in your brick? It should be less than 10%. What happens if it is more than 10%? We will be entering into a phenomena called as efflorescence. Remember this, efflorescence is related to what? It is related to alkalis. What is the story behind this? Let us try to understand. Whenever you are keeping the brick open to the atmosphere, and let us say moisture is now in contact with your brick, or let us say you have dipped this brick in water. Okay. So moisture kya hai? It is in contact with your brick. Now whenever you are drying it again, okay, whenever you are drying this brick again, so water will be evaporated, but there will be a small crystals being formed. The alkalis, whatever are there, no, it will be like a solid crystals after evaporation of water will be forming on your bricks. A powder type form ho jayega, a gray or white powder deposit form ho jayega, and this condition ko hum kya bulate hai? Efflorescence bulate hai. And we also don't like organic matter to be present in our brick. Why? Because the brick we are heating at a very high temperature. If let us say it has some organic compounds in it, so whenever you are heating at high temperature, all this will oxidize and there will be cavities in your brick. Therefore, strength kya ho jayega? Strength gets decreased. Similarly, sulfur is also not a desirable component of our brick. Silicon is desirable. Sulfur ki baat kar raha hu main, sulfur surface. So sulfur is not good because it will make my brick spongy, swollen, tight. Okay. And water, water bhi acha nahi hai. That's why we are drying my brick and then we are burning it. I will teach you in detail. Okay. Next step, which is manufacturing of brick, I will teach you in detail. But water is also not good. Now let us see manufacturing of bricks. See, it has four simple steps. The first step is preparation of clay, molding it into required shape, the rectangular shape, whatever you need, and then it is dried. You can dry it in sun or you can also dry it in sheds. In sheds, what you will be doing, you will be sending hot flue gases and it will be dried. After that, you will be sending it to burning. See, there is a difference between drying and burning. In drying, we are heating only to normal temperature so that the water, whatever is there, no, the moisture, it will be escaped so that it will be efficiently burnt in the next stage. In burning, we will be heating to a very high temperature. Okay. In burning, we keep the bricks in clamp or clean and heat it to a very high temperature. That's the difference. Okay. Now let us see. Coming to preparation of brick earth, whatever we have like unsoiling. Unsoiling means, let us say if this is the ground level, okay, the top 20 centimeters of this ground generally will be very impure, because if there are some trees, the roots will be spread, right? Or plants, the roots will be spread. Organic matter bahut zyada rehta in top 20 centimeters. So basically we dig it and throw it out. So latter, whatever we have, we keep it in piles of 60 centimeter to 120 centimeter. This stage we are calling it as digging. First one is unsoiling. Unsoiling means removing the layer of soil around 20 centimeters, and then digging means we dig the material below it and make it heaps of 20 centimeter, sorry, 60 centimeters to 120 centimeter, and you let it to weather. Okay, you let it to weather for few weeks to full season. So you will let you will just leave it like that. After that, you blend it. If something is missing in the clay, desired properties ke hisab se, you can blend it. After that, you will be mixing it well. Mixing ko hum kya keh rahe? Tempering keh rahe. You can mix. Generally, the people will be mixing it with the help of their foot. Or we also have pug mills. Okay, we also have pug mills. What is a pug mill? I will show you. So once after mixing well, whatever the paste you are getting, no, with the clay paste, we'll be molding in required shapes, and then we'll be drying in the presence of sunlight or sheds, and then we'll be sending it to clamps or kilns, and we'll be finally getting our brick. I hope it is very clear. Unsoiling kitna depth tak karte hai? 20 centimeter, important bit. After that, we dig it and we clean it. In cleaning, if there are any stones and pebbles, obviously we'll be screening and removing it. Okay, and then we'll leave it to the atmosphere for few weeks to the full season. And then we'll be mixing it. Blending mein kya karte? We'll be mixing it with the ingredients, whatever you are required. After that, we'll be tempering it. Okay, we'll be mixing it to a particular degree of hardness. Okay, generally hum kis mein karte hai? Pug mill mein karte hai. Generally feet of men or cattle also it occurs, but pug mill se bhi hum kar lete hai. Pug mill is nothing but it's a mixer. It's like a grinder, you can say. You can see, right? So there is a shaft here. And there are some battens like this. Okay, we are calling them as knives. And whenever this is rotated, the lungs are rotated, this will rotate inside and it will be mixing my clay material. Very simple, right? Generally, this will be tied to cow and the cow will be rotating in a circular fashion. And under mera brick paste will be mixing well. Like that, it happens. So electric motor also can be used. Nothing sci-fi. Very, very general science. Okay, very general things. Next, molding. So the clay paste, whatever you are getting from the pug mill, right? It is made into standard dimensions. You can have hand molding, machine molding. You might have understood, right? Hand molding means by hand. Machine molding by machine. Again, this hand molding, right? It is of two types. One is ground molded bricks. You are molding on ground. And second one is table mounted. You are making on a small table. No need to remember in detail. Kuch important nahi hai. But in this machine molding, there are two types of molding. One is plastic clay machine. Dusra aake dry clay machines. In plastic clay machines, what happens is, a machine ke andar hum jo paste bana hai na, clay paste, it is sent. And when it is coming out into a proper rectangular shape, na, hum kya karte? There will be a string. And it will be cutting it into exactly 19 into 9 into 9. Cut kar lega. There will be a string, there will be a wire which will be cutting it. Therefore, we are calling them as wire cut bricks. Whereas in dry clay machines, what will be having, right? We will be pressing it. There will be a sort of molds and we will be pressing it. The machine will be pressing it over it. Okay. So we will be getting, you can see here, right? It is pressed by a machine. I hope it is very clear, right? So that you will be getting hard and well-shaped bricks. So here what we are doing, we are pressing it in a machine, and the bricks, whatever you are getting, we are calling it as dry clay machines. I hope it is very clear, right? So next is drying. Generally 3 to 4 days tak hum sunlight mein karte hain. Okay. I hope it is very clear. Why we are doing it? So that to bring the moisture content to less than 3%. Therefore, the time taken by bricks in burning will be less and the fuel wastage will also be less. There are two types, open air dryers and artificial dryers. Open air dryers means generally in developing countries we'll be seeing, we'll be just leaving it to like atmosphere and sunlight will take care of it. Artificial dryer means there will be like sheds and hot floor dryers or tunnel dryers will be used. Hum flue gases basically bhi jate hai, hot air bhi jate hai for one around 120 degrees for 1 to 3 days and my whatever bricks are there, right, they will be completely dried. Moisture content will be less than 3%. Once it is achieved, we will be sending it to burning. See, burning we can do it in clamps or kilns. Kilns is scientific. Clamps is like old technology. It's a very old technology. Before there was less scientific development also, we had bricks. No, kaise banate the? Clamps mein banate the. Okay, so actually whenever you are burning, right, these are the stages which it goes through. Three stages, very important. Just let me change the color, let me take a blue one. Yeah, So there are three very important stages. One is dehydration, 400 to 600 degree centigrade. When you start burning it, 400 to 600 degree centigrade के बाद क्या हो जाएगा? Dehydration. That means water is lost, water गायब. Next is oxidation period. See the temperature 650 to 900 degree centigrade. What happens at this temperature? एनवायरमेंट में पड़ा था, इफ यू आर हीटिंग समथिंग टू 600 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, ऑल द ऑर्गेनिक मैटर विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज. सो वॉट एवर कार्बन इज प्रेजेंट, इट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज. नॉट ओनली दैट, द फेरस आयरन वॉट एवर इज देयर, नो, इट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइज टू फेरिक फॉर्म. याद रख लो, टू इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स हैपनिंग इन ऑक्सीडेशन पीरियड एंड टेम्परेचर इज 650 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टू 900 डिग्री. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट इज विट्रिफिकेशन. हियर द टेम्परेचर विल बी अराउंड 900 टू 1100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड फॉर लो मेल्टिंग क्ले, एंड फॉर हाई मेल्टिंग क्ले इट विल बी लाइक 1000 टू 1250 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. ओके, दैट इज इफ यू वॉन्ट हाई रिफ्रैक्टरी ब्रिक्स, देन मोर विल बी द टेम्परेचर एट विच यू विल बी बर्निंग योर ब्रिक्स. वेरी सिंपल, राइट? सो वाई वी आर डूइंग दिस? वेन एवर वी आर हीटिंग इट टू सच अ हाई टेम्परेचर, 900 टू 1100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, वॉट एक्चुअली हैपन्स इज यूर ब्रिक विल बिकम लाइक अ ग्लासी मटीरियल. ओके, इट विल बिकम लाइक अ ग्लास टाइप मटीरियल. इट विल बी गेटिंग लाइक प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक स्ट्रेंथ, हार्डनेस एंड लो मॉइस्चर अब्सॉर्प्शन. आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर, राइट? याद रखोगे. एंड नेक्स्ट, क्लैम्प्स. आई हैव टोल्ड यू बर्निंग कैन हैपन इन टू थिंग्स, क्लैम्प्स और क्लिंस. सो दिस इज हाउ अ क्लैम्प लुक्स लाइक, देखे होंगे कभी. सो फर्स्ट, एट सर्टेन इंक्लिनेशन वॉट यूल बी हैविंग, यूल बी हैविंग फ्यूएल, एंड ऑन फ्यूएल यूल बी हैविंग कोर्सेस ऑफ ब्रिक. 4 to 5 कोर्सेस ऑफ ब्रिक्स हम रखेंगे, एंड देन वी विल बी हैविंग फ्यूएल, and then again 4 to 5 courses of brick fuel, 4 to 5 courses of brick and then fuel. So alternate layers will be having our brick and fuel. This fuel will generally what, cow dung, leaves, dried leaves like this. Okay, because mostly it will happen in villages, the two backward areas mein bahut dekhne ko milega clams even today. So cow dung like this, dried leaves you will be having and you will be burning them. Okay, you will be burning them. So around what is the angle you generally see? The angle will be around like 15 degrees from the ground level. You can see it is projected at some angle, no? So this angle is 15 degrees. See, yaad rakh lo aap. So 4 to 5 courses of the bricks is kept. After that 4 to 5 courses, 70 to 80 centimeter thick layer of fuel is kept. I hope it is very clear, right? And what is the burning period? You just fire this fuel and leave it. Okay, you will. It will be keep on burning for some time, almost like 1 to 2 months tak it will be burning, and after that automatically on its own only it will be start to cool. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? And this is about the clamps, and these are the clins. These are the modern clins, whatever we are using right now. Chimneys rahega, there will be heating chambers, there will be rooms separated like this, there will be rooms separated into different chambers, right? You can see it, right? So these are like industrial type of manufacturing, the modern science of manufacturing. Okay, so coming to the clins, again we have two types, intermittent and continuous. Nami keh raha, intermittent means obviously it is not continuous. Okay, you will be getting batch by batch, whereas continuous clins you will be getting the bricks continuously, ek ke baad ek aate hi rehte hai. These intermittent clins are again of two types, intermittent updraught clin and downdraught clin. Updraught clin generally temporary buildings, whereas downdraught clins that will be permanent buildings. Okay, permanent roofs and permanent walls will be having permanent. So basically in updraught clins you can guess it is a temporary one. The bricks are not uniformly burnt. Yahan pe kya hota hai, you will be having the room, no, you will be just releasing hot flue gases and wait for my bricks to be burnt. Whereas in draught down na aise nahi chalta hai, using the chimney action, the whatever these hot flues, no, they are moved downwards towards from due to the chimney action. It actually moves from top to bottom. Hot gases are moved in which direction? Moved downwards by the chimney draught. And here what is happening, ye jo hot air gases jo bhi hai na, it will make sure that your bricks are uniformly burnt. So what you are getting uniformly burnt bricks. So obviously intermittent draught down cleans produce a better quality bricks compared to intermittent updraught clins. Next is continuous clins. Okay, now let us see continuous clins. So continuous clins, the bricks will be continuously being produced. So there are three types of important clins. One is bull trench clin, Hoffman clin, tunnel clin. Bull trench clin is something which we see very common in India, and then we have Hoffman's clean and tunnel clean. So coming to this bull trench clean, this will be the most used clean in India. Actually, in developing countries, bull trench clean is most frequently used. So what we have is will be there will be like courses of bricks, no, we'll be dropping this fuel from the top and we'll be igniting them and we'll be closing the top wall. Okay, the top from where the fuel is dropped, we'll be closing it. That's it. And we'll be waiting for my bricks to be completely burnt. So that is like bull's trench clean. And next we have Hoffman clean. Hoffman clean ka diagram dekh lo. This is the Hoffman clean. Okay, we'll be having different chambers. Different chambers. Clearly dikh raha hai na? So we'll be having chambers. Ek chambers ke brick agar burn ho gaye to nikal loge. So you will be refilling it. And the next chamber bricks, whatever are burnt, you will be removing it next day like that. Okay, you'll be having continuous supply of bricks. Hoffman's clean. It has superior what control conditions compared to that of bull trench clean. It is little bit expensive and utna common hai. As it is initial cost is high, this is not that common. Only like developed countries you can see it. So obviously the good quality bricks will be produced more in Hoffman compared to that of your bull trench clean. एंड दिस एडवांटेजेस वॉट एवर आर देर नो, ये आपको याद रखना पड़ेगा. ओके, ये आपको याद रखना पड़ेगा. यू कैन टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट. सो वॉट एवर आई एम टीचिंग यू मोर देन एनफ. एंड इफ यू आर रीडिंग द नोट्स वंस राइट, इट विल बी लाइक परफेक्ट फॉर यू. विल बी मोर देन परफेक्ट. नेक्स्ट इज टनल क्लीन. सो देर विल बी अ टनल. देर विल बी लाइक अ टनल एंड यू विल बी सेंडिंग यूर ब्रिक्स थ्रू दिस टनल. ओके, देर विल दिस टनल विल बी हीटेड एंड यू विल बी सेंडिंग द ब्रिक्स through this tunnel and by the time the bricks come out of this tunnel it will be completely burnt. So this is like tunnel clean. So there is a comparison between clamp burning and clean burning. Obviously clamp is like not a perfect one, right? It is like village area, the rural people, old technology, but clean is a good technology. So obviously the quality of bricks will be much higher. You can see the quality of good bricks is 90% in clean burning, whereas in clamp burning it is only 60%. And obviously as anyone can do this, it is not much like the fuel whatever are using are just dried leaves, grass, cow dung. There is no much supervision required. But here whenever you are using cleans, obviously you are operating at a high temperature, like you are using natural gas or coal. Obviously now you should be very careful. Only the skilled persons can take care of it. Okay. And this is another very important bit. So what is the time of burning and cooling? If you are talking about clamps, 2 to 6 months lagega for making the bricks. Whereas when you are burning in cleans, now actual time of burning of one chamber is only about 24 hours and about 12 days are required for cooling of brick. So whereas this clamp is taking 2 to 6 months, this is taking just 24 hours for heating and 12 days for cooling. Okay, I hope you got it right. Yaad rahega. So this is how it is, and I also have a table showing the difference between bull trench clean and Hoffman clean. Zarurat nahi hai. No need to remember. Just remember the high, the cost, initial cost is high in Hoffman. Therefore, it is less prominent. Whereas the initial cost is less when it comes to bull trench clean. So it is very frequently seen in India. So the quality of bricks will be superior in Hoffman's compared to that of bull trench. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? So next let us see tests of brick, and after this the chapter will end. Test of bricks and chapter will end. So there are certain tests for the brick and I will also teach you different types of brick. Okay, so test for brick, the first one is absorption, the water absorption. Kya karna hai aapko? Pani mein rakhna hai and you have to see that your brick whatever is there, if it is a first class, it should not absorb how much? Should not absorb more than 20% of its dry weight. Yaad rakho ke. Next is compressive strength. You already know the compressive strength. If it is a first class, it should be greater than or equals to 10 kilonewton per meter square, right? So second class 7 and third class 3.5. But IS code clearly says if the brick is less than 5.5 kilonewton per meter square, you cannot use. Only you can use if the strength is more than 5.5. Done. Yaad rakhoge. Very simple, right? Next is hardness. So whenever you are like making an impression with your nail, there should not be any impressions left. Okay. Presence of soluble salt. Very important. Give it 5 star. What am I talking about? Presence of soluble salts. That means I'm talking about alkali, potash. Okay. So if it has less than 10%, then white deposit whenever you are keeping it in water, taking out and drying it, white deposit whatever you are having, if it is less than 10% of the area, then it is light efflorescence. If it is less than 50%, moderate efflorescence, greater than 50%, serious efflorescence. Efflorescence itself is bad. Jitna kam hai, utna achha hai. Theek hai? So what about soundness? Whenever you are ringing two bricks, a metallic or a clear ringing sound should come. Tuck, tuck. Okay. So next, structure. Structure kaise rehna chahiye? Obviously, it should be homogeneous, compact, and it should be free from any defects. And most important will be this shape. Yaad rakhlo, baba. Is shape ka jo point hai, this is very important. I have already taught. What is the tolerance limit? Along the length, it is 8 mm. And along the width, it is 4 mm. Along the width, it is 4 mm. Okay. Yaad rakhoge. Galti nahi karoge. Tolerance is 8 and 4. Okay. Done. So, next is, what are the different types of bricks we have? Not only the rectangular bricks, we have different type of bricks as per the requirement. So, these are some of the names which you should remember. Okay. These are some of the names which you should remember. So, generally, bull nosed bricks, hum kahan pe use karte hai? Open drains ke paas use karte hai. Bull nosed. It will be looking like a bull nosed. So, I will show you the structure. So, this is how it looks like bull nosed. That's why generally drains ke paas ab dekhoge aise type of bricks. As it is looking like a bull nose, we are calling it as bull nose bricks. Okay. So, canned bricks bhi hai. So, for doors and window jams, we'll be using these canned bricks. Double canned bricks are also there. These are my canned bricks. And this will be my double canned bricks. Okay. Double canned bricks. So, generally at doors and window jams, we'll be using them. And then we have this cornice brick. Cornice brick kahan pe use karte hai? Architectural point of view, cornice brick will be something like this. It will be something like this. Okay, it could be of any shape. Okay, like this. You can see, no? I say jo shapes mein hai, we will be calling them as cornice brick. We'll be calling them as cornice brick. We have perforated bricks, we have hollow bricks, and we have coping bricks. Coping bricks kaise rahenge? Triangular, these type of things. Generally kahan pe? Upar jo ghar ke upar banate hai, parapet wall. On it, we'll be using this coping type of things. No, on parapet wall, you generally see coping type of bricks in some houses, not mandatory. Okay. And we'll also have king closure, queen closure. I will teach you this in detail when I'm teaching masonry. In masonry, I will teach you off bat, queen closure, king closure, like what is English bond, Flemish bond, everything I will teach you when I'm teaching masonry, not in bricks chapter. Bricks mein sirf bricks padhai karenge. So, there are some special types of brick, like heavy duty brick. Remember the code book, very important. IS 2180 is related to heavy duty brick. And there are two classes. Heavy duty bricks are of two classes. Class 400, whose strength is greater than 40 Newton per mm square. I am calling them as class 400, and whose strength is greater than 450. I am 45 Newton per mm square. 45 Newton per mm square. I am calling them as class 450. Class 450. Okay. Done. Next, water absorption of this heavy duty bricks. Now, it should not be, actually, it should not be less, not more than 5% basically, but up to 10% you can have, but not more than 10%. Done. And what is the temperature resistance of heavy duty bricks? 1500 to 1650 degrees. That means, even if due to some fire accident, if the temperature rises up to 1650 degrees centigrade also, my bricks will not melt. I hope it is very clear, right? Medium duty 1300 to 1500, low duty less than 870. Very important table, yaad rakhna padega. Heavy duty 1500 to 1650, medium 1300 to 1500, low duty less than 870. And then perforated bricks, you already know. What is the IS code book? 2222. IS code book kitna hai? 2222. And perforations should not be more than 30 to 40%, 45% of the area. And water absorption should not be more than 15%. Heavy duty kitna? Should not be greater than 10%. Here, it should not be greater than 15%. And compressive strength should not be less than 10 Newton per mm square. 10 Newton per mm square. So, next, paving bricks. Obviously, for pavement purpose, we will be using this.
जनरली द आयरन कंटेंट विल बी वेरी हाई, द आयरन कंटेंट विल बी वेरी हाई. क्यों? विट्रिफिकेशन ऑफ ब्रिक्स के लिए, एक नेचुरल ग्लेज आने के लिए हम क्या करते हैं, आयरन कंटेंट थोड़ा बढ़ा देते हैं इन अवर पेविंग ब्रिक्स. एंड ऑब्वियसली द स्ट्रेंथ शुड नॉट बी लेस देन 40 Nm/mm² एंड वाटर अब्सॉर्प्शन शुड नॉट बी मोर देन 5% ऑफ इट्स वेट. नेक्स्ट वी हैव सोलिंग ब्रिक्स. फॉर सोलिंग पर्पज ऑफ द रोड्स विल बी हैविंग द सोलिंग ब्रिक्स. ज्यादा कुछ जरूरत नहीं है, इट्स लाइक मोर लाइक अ फिलर. सो द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ जनरली इट शुड नॉट बी लेस देन 5 Nm/mm² काफी है. एंड वाटर अब्सॉर्प्शन शुड नॉट बी मोर देन 20% ऑफ इट्स वेट आफ्टर 24 hours ऑफ इमर्शन इन वाटर. नेक्स्ट इज हॉलो ब्रिक्स. यू ऑलरेडी नो हॉलो ब्रिक्स क्या रहता है, देर विल बी हॉलो स्पेसेस इन माई ब्रिक्स. इसे क्या होगा, माई ब्रिक्स विल बिकम लाइटर, माई वेट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर विल बिकम लाइटर एंड obviously it will also help us in temperature resistance, thermal resistance as well as sound resistance. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? So they also reduce transmission of heat, sound and dampness also. That's why hollow bricks are preferred. In many countries aajkal normal bricks nahi use kar rahe, hollow bricks hi use kar rahe hai. So minimum average value of strength it should be 3.5 Nm/mm², but anyway IS code ne clearly kaha hai, if something is less than 5.5 Nm², we will not be using it. Okay, refractory bricks. Refractory bricks are those bricks which can take high temperature. If bricks can take around like 1700 degrees centigrade, we generally call it as refractory bricks. They are just not temperature resistant, but they are also acid resistant. Okay, next, there is a classification of bricks. Actually, mains mein pucha gaya tha this classification, not important, but mains mein pucha gaya tha, isliye padha tha. So we know first class, second class, right? And third class and fourth class. That's one type of classification. But here we have a different type of classification. So first is grade A. If the strength is greater than 14 Nm/mm². Kitna? 14 Nm/mm² or you can write it as 140 kg/cm², up to you. 14 Nm/mm² se zyada hai, grade A brick. If it is greater than 10.5 Nm/mm², then it is first class. Second class will be greater than 7 Nm/mm² and class 3 bricks or grade C bricks, it should be greater than 3.5 Nm/mm². Done. So just grade A ka extra hai, wo yaad rakh lena hai aapko. How much is it? 140 kg/cm² or if you convert the unit, 14 Nm/mm². So there are some more code books I have given. If you have time, just have a look. Okay, just have a look. No need to remember. So whatever code books I have given here, no, only that you have to remember. Hollow bricks 3952, swelling brick 5779, paving brick 3583. Why? Because in multiple choice, match the following questions, this type of IS codes can come. So remember at least 2-3 so that you can match. Hollow ka yaad rakh lo 3952, swelling 5779, and perforated bricks to kafi easy hai, 2222. And heavy duty 2180. So remember 4-5 more than enough. So here I am concluding this chapter of bricks. I hope you have enjoyed a lot. In the next chapter, we will be seeing the entire, in the next module, we will be seeing the entire cement and finish. Have a nice day. See you in next module.